promise to take advantage of single best kids shows in existence. It's a funny, heartwarming, wholesome program. However, starting with the fifth season, the show got far more violent, but I still loved it. However, something that happened concerning the show's third season has tested my resolution on the show. I've been trying to suppress memories of the episodes in question, but I think the time of coming to tell my story is now, and I don't regret it in the slightest. It was one summer ago, exactly a week after that year's 4th of July. I'd been staying my grandparents for about a week while my parents went on a business trip. At around 2:30 in the morning, I woke up very suddenly with a stomach bug like no other. It felt like I was being possessed. I was sleeping in the downstairs TV room, so I decided to turn on the TV, foolishly hoping it would help me fall back asleep. I decided to tune PBS Kids. Maybe I told myself Thomas the Tank Engine would be on, so I switched on the TV and turned to PBS. A commercial concerning the premiere of a new season of Arthur that was to air Wednesday morning was on. I watched the whole commercial and the whole screen went to black, save for a small white flashing dot in the top left-hand corner, accompanied by just audible beeping. It went on for 60 seconds, realizing I should record this. I quickly grabbed a blank VHS tape, popped it into play, and hit the record button. About a minute, the screen changed. It went on to an army green card with some rigid-looking white text that said the following message. The following broadcast that you're about to see is a bat and episode from the third season of Thomas the Tank Engine. It was only aired once before, or on August 16, 2005. It was pulled from airing because of the brutal death of the two well-loved characters. The episode's heroes were written and adapted in its place. This is the last time it's going to be aired. Watch it at your own risk. This stayed on scene. Screen for about 30 seconds, accompanied by some just visible static. After that, the episode began. The opening was normal with the catchy music of Thomas helping Terry pass the part where the episode's title was showed display the name The Quarry Disaster. Assuming this was nothing more than a rarely aired version of Snow Engine or something like that, I just kept watching. The episode started off with dark footage of the opening scene of the episode with the Diesel. The narrative said that Bill and Ben were good, hardworking quarry engines that loved their job. Then show some B-roll footage of the two engines pulling some trucks between two mountains while the camera moves upwards and away from them. Then it cuts to a shot of Bill, Ben in their shed with their top hat in front of them. Bill, Ben, the quarry mountain up in the mountain needs some heavy repairs. What are you saying here, sir? Said Bill, sounding somewhat confused. I'm saying the two of you are the best engines for a job, replied the Chopper Hat. Oh joy, we love the mountain, gleefully said Ben. The just visible static then got significantly worse to the point where almost nothing was recognizable, with Bill and Ben merely being yellow blobs. After about 30 seconds of this, it got better, at a point where showed Bill and Ben sitting on a bridge in the mountain and quarry. The narrator said that they felt ill and started to catch some air on a bridge. They got to an incline with some troublesome trucks on it. This is boring, said one truck. Let's make some trouble, said another. So they started tugging at the winch. The narrator said that Bill and Ben had realized what had happened, and they were trying to get off the bridge, but they were unable to move. Our wheels are too full of rocks, Bill moaned. My whistle's full of sand, Ben shouted. When the winch finally broke and the truck started rolling towards the bridge, Bill tried to whistle for help, but it was all too late. The trucks collided with the bridge's wooden supports, which were weak, triggering it to collapse, taking Bill and Ben with it. But a very loud boom was heard as while the bridge was taking Bill and Ben as it collapsed. The camera cuts to a shot of the rocks tumbling down one of the surrounding mountains. It cuts to a shot of Bill's perspective in first person of a large rock falling on top of him. It went to a bird's eye view of the whole affair, just as the rock landed on Bill with a crunch that's with a hard stomping noise. From a distance, I was treated to a scene of a rock sweeping Bill and Ben. The bridge and six trucks, which had caused this whole accident in first place down the mountain in the valley below, it then faded to black with some just audible buzzing in the background. It then went to a rather wide shot of the first 11 engines, plus George, Burko, Mavis, Daisy in the harbor all gathered up around with two unidentifiable objects loaded onto the flatbeds, which looks of frantic worry upon their faces. When the camera moved a little closer to the flatbeds, I realized what they were, with a shiver going down my spine. Bill and Ben, but they were totally unrecognizable. Their paint was gone, Ben's face and cracked. Between them had six missing wheels. Both of the bodies had been exploded, what appears, and at the same time, melted. The place where their funnels should have been was smoking rather copiously. Both of their buffers were twisted badly. Bill's funnel was emitting an eerie screeching noise from a large crack down the center, and they both had an oddly burned look around them. What happened? Said Ben weakly. There was a rock slide, said Edward. You two were found in the valley near the site of a crash by me and the Dougie, said Donald. A slight quack wake in his voice. Facility repairs works can't handle this kind of damage. Burko said, his voice sounding choked up. Where are we going? Bill croaked. Overseas, Mavis weakly replied. Percy then pushed their flatbeds towards the loading dock, and they were loaded onto what looked like a large, chocolate-colored, faceless, steam-powered balustrade. They cut to an audioless scene of a boat splashing around in some very stormy-looking waters. It went on like this for about a minute or two. What happened next still leaves me with chills. A lightning bolt hit the boat's funnel. An abnormally large wave hit the part of the boat where Bill and Ben were loaded. From the captain's cabin was an odd howling issue. After it peered out, the boat had disappeared, probably going to a watery grave. It then cut to the credits. I let the credits roll and stopped recording and ejected the tape. I probably fell back asleep until about 10:30 that morning. I was awakened by the sound of a commercial of a marathon of Thomas episodes from seasons 2-6, Until the Cows Come Home. Started right after that. What was odd that the episode with Bill Ben in them from both seasons were absent from this marathon. Not the disease, or not heroes, not even Percy taking a plunge. Where were their names after even mentioned? Did the airing of the quarry just mess with the normal broadcast of the day? Even odder, when I decided to watch the tapes with as well as One Good Turn. If anybody has a copy of this episode, please send it to me. I just have one question. Why would someone make something like this in the first place?